Hi everyone, Sariana van As here with another art journaling tutorial for Stencil-Art. All products used in this video will be listed at the end of the video and are available at www.stencilart.co.za. As always, I make use of my Strathmore Visual Journal with Bristol Smooth Paper. I placed a piece of wax paper behind the page I'm working on to protect the rest of my journal, as I'm always quite messy. If you have watched some of my other videos, you will know that I love colored backgrounds. To challenge myself today, I decided to try to stick to a plain white background. I covered my page with white acrylic paint. I'm using Dina Wakley heavy-bodied acrylic paints for this page. This will give me a nice smooth surface to work on. You can also use gesso if you prefer. This will also cover any marks and other stains on the page. Make sure that the paint is completely dry before moving on to the next step. Use a charcoal pencil to draw the outlines of four of the birds on the birds in a row stencil. This stencil includes the cutout images, the masks, as well as the details of the birds. Use white acrylic paint to pull the charcoal into the image to create a grayscale bird. This technique will also work with other water-soluble pencils like Derwent pastel, inktense, or charcoal pencils. This also fixes the charcoal so that you can layer other mediums on top. Use patterned paper to draw and cut out the other bird. You can click on the video link on the screen to see how I created this patterned wax paper using foam stamps. Mark your placement of the bird using the stencil and adhere the colored bird image with a matte medium. Make sure that it is laying flat with no air trapped underneath, otherwise it is going to start lifting. It will also look like I painted the bird on the page. The other birds were too shiny next to the colored bird, so I painted matte medium on top to give them all the same finish. Use the stencil to add details to the birds and use white acrylic paint to fix the charcoal. This will also blend the detailed lines into the background and give it a painterly look. I'm doing the same with a colored bird, but this time using an inktense pencil and lime colored acrylic paint. I'm also pulling the colors inwards so that it does not look like I outlined the bird. This will give you a graduated colored look with the color the darkest on the outside and lighter towards the middle. I'm adding yellow and blue acrylic paint to create some interest and details to the bird. This heavy body acrylic paint stays wet a bit longer than the other acrylics, so you have some open time to blend it together. Add a white dot as a highlight in each of the bird's eyes. This will make them immediately look alive. I've done the design and placement of my quote on Microsoft Word and printed it out. I'm using transfer paper to draw my quote on my page. You can find the PDF file of this quote on my blog. It is not always easy, but try not to touch the transfer paper too much, as the charcoal will easily transfer even finger marks to your page. You can always just erase these unwanted marks, so don't panic too much. You cannot really see the words on the video, but it looks like pencil lines and really quite visible. I'm going over these lines with my big brush pens. These pens are filled with India ink and permanent once dry. I decided to use the same technique on the copy birds and use my charcoal pencil and white acrylic paint. add some interest and detail to the words with different colors of big brush pens. You do get the Faber-Castell Pitt Artist pens with a smaller nib filled with the same India ink if you prefer a thinner line. Use the big brush pens to add some more details to the birds. These pens work best over non-porous surfaces and is quite translucent, so that layers underneath are still visible. That is why this is my preferred way of shading as well, and permanent once dry. Write the name of the person who wrote the quote with a black big brush pen. I changed over to a finer point as the nib of the big brush pen was just too big. Also use the fine nib to outline the word copy. I use the swirl stencil and an intense pencil to add swirls behind the birds. This will anchor the birds as it looked like they were floating in the air. Just connect the gaps that was left by the stencil and add some more swirls and curls, either freehand or with the stencil. Use a water brush to activate the intense pencil. This will also fix the pencil so that it becomes permanent once dry. Some of the lines will go on top and others behind. This technique is also easier if it is done on a non-porous surface. The color sinks into the paper if it is not sealed. Added the date so long and then added shading with the Pitt Artist pens. You can easily blend this ink while it is still wet. The eyes were disappearing, so I just went over it with a black big brush pen and added the highlight again with my white Sharpie paint pen. I outlined some of the words with a black Pitt Artist pen and added more details with my big brush pens. I did not like the painterly look of the swirl, so I neatened it up with my big brush pen. Thank you so much for joining me again.